tried their hand at putting together the wonderful story of Jesus' birth, which has been handed down to us through reports from original eyewitnesses and subsequently ended up in scripture and history books. Today, we're going to take a look inside the story with a glimpse of some of the emotions that are going on inside the characters' minds throughout these events. I am pleased to introduce these emotions, who will let us in on some of the battles of the mind the characters experienced. Here we have joy, anger, disgust, fear, and sadness. We will meet these emotions as we see each character. Keep an eye on the screen to see what they are feeling throughout the play. Before we get to Jesus' birth, we need to explain another miracle of birth. There was a couple, Zechariah and Elizabeth. They lived very honourably in God's eyes, although interestingly, they were quite old and still had no children.
So what are you doing today, Liz?
Oh, I thought I might go to markets.
So much, and thanks God for being so faithful over so many years and bringing her so much peace and joy.
What are you on? Seriously? God doesn't care about her. All she wanted was a little baby, and did he give it to her? No! He didn't give her the one thing that she wanted. He doesn't care about her at all.
You mean God doesn't care about Elizabeth anymore? No!
Oh, it can't be. I don't think she could go on without God's love.
Maybe he just thinks Elizabeth is not good enough.
Come on, you guys. Of course God loves Elizabeth. We just need to be faithful and trust him. It doesn't mean that God doesn't love her.
Okay, Liz, I'm off to the temple to burn some incense to do some jobs.
Are you serious? God can't stand them. That's why he's trying to end their line. No little Zackies or Lizzies for them.
Obviously there's nothing good about Zechariah to be passing on.
What has he done wrong, God? Why are you pushing him?
What if he's been so bad that God takes away his Elizabeth?
Oh, stop stressing, guys. God loves them and Zechariah has so much faith. We just need to keep praying.
So Zechariah walks into the temple and begins to burn some incense and pray to God. When unannounced, an angel appears. Zechariah was paralyzed with fear.
By Angry's tiny beard, he's gonna die! Run! Run!
Don't be afraid, Zechariah. God has heard your prayers. Elizabeth will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will call him John. You are going to leap like a gazelle for joy, and it will bring much joy to many people.
Yay!
Stop it! You're crazy! Just let the angel finish his message!
Your son will be filled with the Spirit of God from the time he exits his mother's womb. He will bring many back to God.
But how can that be? I am an old man, and my wife is an old lady.
Finally, he's making some sense. This is just not right.
Oh, come on. God hasn't forgotten about Zechariah. Look, he's answering our prayers.
I am Gabriel, the angel sent to give you this message. But because you did not believe me, you will be unable to speak until the time your son is born.
Ha! That'll teach you people not to listen and believe. When will you people learn?
Surely this will bring people closer to God and show them the power of him.
Meanwhile, outside, the people were waiting for Zechariah and wondering what was keeping him for so long. When he came out and couldn't speak, they knew he had seen a vision. He spoke to them with sign language to explain what had happened.
Seth can't even speak sign language. They're never going to understand him.
Oh, don't think about that. Imagine when Elizabeth hears the news. It's so exciting. They're having a baby. They're really having a baby.
So Zachariah heads home after his assignment at the temple and tells Elizabeth. It's not long before she conceives and she feels every emotion possible.
Oh, she's going to get super sick. Ah!
How is she going to be a good mother? She's so old.
The emotions are real.
6 months pass. And God sends Gabriel back with a message for a virgin named Mary, who is wandering along the path. And he tells her that she's going to have a baby too.
Bizarre assignments.
There's no way that they're going to believe this message. And then what happened?
Come on, this is the greatest assignment ever. We get to share this news to everyone, and it's going to change the world.
What will everyone think of it? God, I hope you know what you're doing. Here we go.
Good morning. You are beautiful inside and out. God be with you. He is going to be a great and mighty king, and there will be no end to his kingdom.
But I'm not married to Joseph yet, and I've never slept with a man.
What do you mean Mary has nothing to fear? This is freaking me out!
Does this guy know nothing about the birds and the bees and how it works?
How will Joseph ever marry Mary? He won't understand.
Mary's definitely going to be shunned when people find out that she's pregnant and isn't married.
Nothing is impossible with God. This is crazy exciting. Quick, say yes before it is someone else.
Don't worry. God is very capable of this. Just think of your cousin Elizabeth, who conceived, even in her old age.
Yes, I understand now. I am the Lord's maid, ready to serve.
So the angel left, and Mary didn't waste a minute racing to visit her cousin Elizabeth's house. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting,
Elizabeth!
The baby in her womb leapt, and she was filled with the Holy Spirit and sang a song.
Your baby boy has walked the angels' throne.
another significant person that Mary was forgetting. And needless to say, when Joseph found out the news, he was not exactly happy.
What do you mean you're pregnant with God's son, Mary? Please explain.
As if that's God's son. Mary's in for a shock if she thinks Joe's going to stick around for this.
Oh my goodness. What is everybody going to say? This is so embarrassing.
This is the end of a perfectly good relationship.
How can you do this, Mary? Come on. Joe knows Mary. Maybe there is some truth to what she is saying.
I know it sounds crazy, Joseph, but an angel of the Lord appeared to me and told me I'd be pregnant with God's son. And I thought it would be impossible, but then he reminded me of Elizabeth's miracle baby in her old age.
Yeah,
but
at least she has a husband.
I don't think Joe could ever believe this. I think there's going to be a breakup.
When Joseph was sleeping that night, an angel appeared to him in a dream and explained everything to him.
Joseph, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife. The child in her womb has been conceived of the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will save the people from their sins. This is God's plan.
Fortunately, Joseph believed the angel, rose from his sleep, and took Mary as his wife. He didn't sleep with her until after her child was born.
That was the dumbest thing you ever agreed to!
Definitely a hard decision, but worth it. When you think about the bigger picture of God's plan, Joe doesn't want to mess that up.
It wasn't long before Elizabeth and Zachariah had their baby boy. When he was born, Elizabeth told everyone that his name was to be John. Their friends objected and thought he should be called Zachariah like his father. When they asked Zachariah what he thought, he wrote on a tablet, "His name's to be John." The people were surprised at that. But even more surprised when Zachariah started to speak again and sang praises to God.
John!
Praise God! All you have said has happened!
Finally! Zach can speak again! That was so annoying!
More time passes, and when Mary is very pregnant, the king orders a census. So Mary and Joseph need to get from Nazareth to Bethlehem quickly. Joseph looks for a donkey to make Mary's journey easier.
Don't you dare choose this old donkey! We do not want to be going to Bethlehem! We are more than happy just munching on some of this delicious grass.
I don't want to go! I don't want to go!
Yikes! Is she still her husband done for?
Look at how big she is! Wow!
I'm all alone. Ain't nobody here beside me.
But come on, guys. This is a chance for Donkey to have a friend. And I have a feeling it's going to be some ride.
So off they head, all the way to Bethlehem. Before long, they were very thirsty. Fortunately, there was an ancient slushy stand on the way.
I want to go home. Please
They knock on many doors. And finally, find a hotel owner who says they can use the shed out the back where the animals are kept.
Smell it, but it'll be a roof over your head.
Note to self, never trust a man to find good accommodation.
And while they were there, Mary gave birth to her son, Jesus. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger.
Yeah.
shepherds raced off instantly to Bethlehem to find the manger where Jesus lay.
How on earth are we going to find that inn?
I'm sure if God sent us an angel,
they ran to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the baby. Seeing was believing. They told everyone what the angels had said about this child and were very excited and full of praise for God. Now also in our story, there were some very clever men, a band of three scholars who knew many things. They observed a star, which was moving around in the sky, and knew that it indicated the birth of Jesus, King of the Jews. Word got around that they were looking for this newborn king, and King Herod heard and was feeling threatened. He was not happy, and he called the wise men to him in order to trick them and find this baby.
Where can we find this child? I want to worship him too.
How dare they talk about a baby being a king? King Herod is the king!
What if this baby takes over from Herod and is better than him?
Oh, a baby? Oh, be quiet! Babies are ghastly!
This could be the end of Herod.
The wise men assure Herod that they don't know where he is yet, but they're following a star which will show them.
We don't know, we're just following the star.
The wise men leave and look again for the star. They find it and follow till it hovers over the child.
It stinks in here! Doesn't matter where he's born,
they've given their gifts, everyone fusses over the baby. Hallelujah! How incredible! What a great plan God had to send his son to save the world. And thus ends the Inside Christmas story.
Take one. joke.
What's going to happen now? Mary's going to have a baby on the top.
Don't you dare choose this old donkey! We are do not want to
We are do not!
Who the heck is this guy? What's going on?
Damn it, Trevor! Do not choose this old donkey! Serious. God can't stand them.
He doesn't hate them. Finally, Zach can talk again. That was so annoying.
I jumped before she said a lot.
Possibly be God's son. Mary's in for a massive shock if she thinks that Joe's sticking around.
Goodness!
Oh my goodness!
Yikes!
They don't ready.
Baby's a legend.
And cut.
Yes!